New information on breaking news we brought you last night at 10.
Police confirm a Bermingham County firefighter barricaded himself at his northeast Albuquerque home with a two-year-old after smoking spice. Action 7 News reporter Liz McKernan joins us live from UNMH.
And right now, Bernalillo County officials say they will wait until the firefighter recovers from his injuries before making any decision as to his employment, as to those actions of allegedly smoking a mind-altering substance.
The scene put a neighborhood on lockdown. Police swarming Panorama Loop Northeast after a woman called 911 claiming her husband smoked an herb like spice or K2 and stopped breathing. Within moments, gunshots rang out, and the woman ran outside after telling police her toddler was still in the house. Police say the man locked the front door, barricading himself inside. After talking to cops over the phone, the firefighter gave up. When he walked out, authorities saw the 29-year-old had shot himself in the face with a pistol, and he was rushed to a hospital for treatment. The two-year-old found safe in bed, somehow still asleep.
We spoke to friends of the firefighter who tell us he was headed into surgery late this afternoon. His family completely devastated by last night's tragic events.
Bernalillo County officials say firefighters are drug tested before they're hired and can be randomly tested at any time. But right now, no one is tested for synthetic marijuana, substances like K2 and spice. Bernalillo County says the company that conducts the drug tests is working on making that option available.
Now, just within the hour, the family of that firefighter released a statement claiming that he never barricaded himself inside the house, that the door in the front of the house actually has a self-locking mechanism. Now, as to the drug testing, Bernalillo County doesn't test for that substance. However, there are labs that can detect it.
But Liz, substances like K2 and spice are illegal.
Well, those brands, they have chemical compounds that are banned. However, cops tell us that these manufacturers just keep coming up with new chemical compounds that mimic THC, which gives the mind-altering effects of marijuana. And you can find those products still in gas stations and smoke shops. Doug?
Right. So far, police have not charged the man with any crime. He remains in critical condition at the